Hey there, thinkers, and welcome back to Critical Hit. My name is Est, and it looks like the Force wasn't strong enough with this one. It seems that the Acolyte couldn't cut it in a galaxy far, far away. Disney Plus has decided to pull the plug, and season 2 is now non-existent. Apparently, even the dark side couldn't keep this series alive, so if you were hoping for more brooding villains and shadowy plots, you're out of luck. Guess the Force decided to take a rain check on this one.
So the Acolyte was canceled.
It's definitely because incels didn't like two people of color holding hands. We're not gonna forget that.
They've hit the second tower.
This article is from Deadline. And yes, I know I've already called this last week. The Acolyte getting canceled is about as surprising as the sun rising in the east. I mean, come on. Let's be honest, with only 33 million views for the season finale, the writing just wasn't on the wall. It was practically carved in stone. However, I do have a few things to show off here, but before I do, we have a small request. If you are new here, consider hitting that subscribe button, smashing that like, and ring the bell to be notified for our next video. We would greatly appreciate this, since this will help us appease those YouTube algorithm gods. So, we thank you. Now, let's get into this. Exclusive, the Acolyte just got the chop. Lucasfilm decided it was time to force choke any hopes of a second season for the Star Wars spinoff starring Amandla Stenberg. According to sources spilling the tea to Deadline, it seems like the galaxy far, far away wasn't far enough to save this show. This news drops more than a month after the 8-episode first season limped to the finish line on Disney+. Courtesy of Leslie Hedlin. Now, despite Hedlin juggling every possible title, creator, director, executive producer, and showrunner, it looks like all that effort just couldn't keep the Acolyte from fading into the void. Maybe, just maybe, next time she'll learn that even the most dedicated Sith apprentices still need a decent script to survive. However, naturally, as soon as Deadline dropped this bombshell, fans wasted no time chiming in. And the reaction was about as harsh as you'd expect. This is just one clip.
It was set up to fail from the beginning. When the Acolyte was first announced as a female-run show with Leslie Hedlund at the helm, starring a black femme and a diverse cast of characters unlike we had seen in a Star Wars project before, the review bombers took to the internet before the show even had a chance to air. Amandla Stenberg, who not only gave a phenomenal performance as Osha, but also as her twin sister May, had no choice but to stick up for themselves and defend herself against the vitriol and bigotry that she was receiving because Lucasfilm did not protect her. Lucasfilm didn't do anything to protect the cast and the crew of the Acolyte. The viewership was not bad. The precedent this is setting is very scary and very concerning. What Lucasfilm is doing with this decision is allowing the bigots to win, allowing the bigots to run with this and decide, even if that's not the original intention of canceling the show, that they have won, that they are correct, that Star Wars needs to be white and male and it can't be anything else.
And I mean, of course they should cancel this train wreck. Who even bothered watching it? This wasn't some hot take. It's been the prevailing sentiment for weeks. Disney's pathetic spin on those first day numbers as a sign of success was nothing more than a desperate attempt to save face. The truth? The show was a complete, utter flop right from the get-go. Now, interest in this series evaporated faster than moisture on Tatooine, with each new episode marking a further decline in viewership. By the time the finale rolled around, it was quite evident just what a colossal failure the show had become. The finale's viewership hit a new low for a Disney Star Wars series, a staggering 50% less than the Andor finale and around 40% behind Ahsoka's closing episode. This wasn't just a minor disappointment, it was a catastrophic failure that should have never gotten off the ground. The entire premise of the show was flawed. The numbers only confirmed what everybody already knew. This was a disaster that should have been canceled before it even had the chance to tarnish the Star Wars name. The fact of the matter is that this show is a glaring testament of how out of touch this tiny group really is. The Acolyte was blatantly pandering to the echo chamber of pronouns and bio, stan account zealots, and flag-waving social media warriors, just like those who worshipped it. From the showrunner to the writers to even the casting choices, every decision was drenched in identity politics rather than any real story. They made it crystal clear right from the start that the plot was a secondary concern. Their main focus was diversity and representation. Well, congratulations. You got exactly what you asked for. And what did you get? The biggest flop in Star Wars history. Maybe it's time to face the facts. You might actually be the minority. Perhaps all those you love to label as misogynistic or racist are just people who want Star Wars to make sense. Like, stay true to its roots and not wreck the franchise. Maybe, just maybe, you're the real problem here. The Acolyte's cancellation is just gonna stoke the flames of the most insufferable corner of the fanbase. You know, the ones who gleefully joined in on the hate train without even bothering to watch the show, simply because they lack the capacity for independent thought. Disney needs to stop pandering to those pathetic losers. Remember when Kathleen Kennedy said a decade ago that they didn't need the old male fanbase anymore because they were aiming for a fresh new audience? Well, guess what? That fresh new audience is exactly who Disney tried to cater to with a $180 million budget. And how did that turn out? Almost universally hated by everyone who bothered to watch it, with barely any interest generated. So seriously, who else are they supposed to cater to? It's clear that this strategy was a financial disaster. They tried to appease you, the fringe, insignificant part of the fandom, and it fucking backfired. Star Wars is collapsing under the weight of the loudest, least representative part of the fanbase. How ironic is that? It's amazing how you can't see that you are the small, obnoxious, worst part of the fanbase. Despite all your tweets and hashtag Renew the Acolyte campaigns with its 6,600 signatures on the petition that started 2 days ago on the 20th, this show wasn't renewed because no one actually watched it.
What do you mean it wasn't bringing in the view?
The Acolyte was an unmitigated disaster. It didn't just miss the mark. No, no. It plummeted off the radar. The show was so bad that it only made sense if it'd be part of a more broader trend of epic failures. Ironically, while the creators tried to pander to the most vocal, self-absorbed segment of the fanbase, the ones, you know, the ones glued to social media, possibly still living in their parents' basements and mooching off their Disney Plus accounts, this show only proved how out of touch they are. This loud, identity politics-obsessed crowd doesn't represent the real Star Wars audience.
Ask me what I'm about to do. I'm about to cry. Thank you for asking.
The truth is, the vast majority of Star Wars fans had absolutely zero interest in The Acolyte. Those who gave it a shot were left unimpressed and frustrated. It's a real shame if you personally enjoyed it, but let's be honest, for the overall Star Wars fanbase, this cancellation was a blessing. This show never had any business getting a second season. From a financial perspective, it was a total flop, recording the lowest viewership numbers in the franchise history, and only getting worse as it dragged on, and I mean it really dragged on. This show is a textbook example of failure, and while its most vehement defenders are struggling to come to terms with it, Lucasfilm made the only sense decision by pulling the plug. The Acolyte is a disaster of epic proportions, and there's no denying that its cancellation was a necessary move to salvage any remaining credibility. However, those are my thoughts on the Acolyte's cancellation. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And hey, before you go, subscribe to our channel, smash that like button, and ring the bell to be notified for our next video. As always, this is us, and I'm signing off now. So I'll see you in the next one. Toodles!